Today, I'm going to show you how to make some simple stairs in 3 or 4 clicks with no geometry nodes or modeling. To start off, I'll press Shift A and then under Mesh, I'm going to choose Cube. Then all I need to do is press Tab to go into Edit Mode, and I can press 2 to go into Edge Select Mode. Then all I need to do is left click one of my edges here, which I want to add stairs to, and then I'm going to do the first step, which is to press Control B. That's going to enable the Bevel command. And now you'll notice that this menu here appears. It might start off like this, so it'll be a little box to you, so you just left click it to open. Then all we need to do is left click this Custom, and here you can notice that if I make an edit here, we can create a custom curve. Nothing will be seen just now, and that's because our segments are only at 1, and these dots here represent vertices. So I'm going to press, and now you can see, if I move this dot, the bevel is reflected here. So of course you can make stairs manually with this, but thankfully it comes with a preset. So you can just left click this drop down and choose steps. Now we have 2 steps, which isn't quite enough. So we can just come up to the top here and increase the segments. So I can maybe increase it to a number like 20. And then beside preset, an apply preset button will now appear, which will allow us to reset it. So I'll press apply preset, and now you can see we've got some more steps. Since we put in the number 20, that will generate 11 steps, because essentially how it works is to calculate how many stairs you create, you have the number of segments plus 1. So here we have 11 steps. This works as well. If I set it to 10 and then press apply preset again, we now have 6 steps. This is great and all, but if I left click away, you can notice I have no way of editing my stairs, and I want to make it so I can edit the stairs at any point. So I'll press Ctrl Z to undo all those changes, and I'm going to press Tab to go back into object mode. In this menu here, I'm going to come down to this blue spanner, which is called the Modifier Properties menu. Then under Add Modifier, I'll left click, and I'm just going to search for bevel. Straight away, you can see this has added some bevels to all edges on our object. I can change this amount, just like I can change with the manual bevel, to increase the size of what I want my steps to be. If I was to go ahead and do the custom profile right now, it would just add steps everywhere, and we only want to have it on one edge. Thankfully, we can do this using a cool feature called Bevel Weight, which allows us to tell the bevel modifier only use certain edges. So I'll press Tab to go into Edit Mode, and I'm going to press N to open this side menu here, and under Transform, you'll see we have something called Bevel Weight. So what I can do is left click an edge. You can click this button here to go into Edge Select Mode, or press 2 on the keyboard, and I'm going to set the bevel weight to 1. Right now, nothing will change, because right now we're using this angle limit method instead of using the bevel weight. So I'll change it from angle to weight, and now you can see it's using the edge that we've weighted, and I can increase my amount here, just like I done with the manual bevel. Then I'm going to come down to profile, and I'm going to change it from super ellipse to custom. Again, we'll have a curve again, and I can just choose my steps preset. I can increase my segments. Maybe I'll give it a segment of 15 and press apply preset. Now we have some more stairs. But the benefit with this is we can change this at any point in time, and if I press Tab to go into edit mode, it hasn't made a permanent change yet. This is great, and this is what people refer to when they say procedural workflows, as you can adjust things at any time. It's also considered a non-destructive workflow, as these changes aren't permanent. And if you want to remove the steps, you simply press this X button, and now you don't have anything again. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo that. You can also make the changes permanent by left clicking this arrow here and pressing apply. Now when I press Tab to go into edit mode, you can see we've got a bunch of steps. I'll press Ctrl Z to undo that. If you're wanting to learn more about different modifiers and cool tricks like these, I recommend checking out my playlist on modifiers. Thank you so much for watching, and take care.